in the process of their whole project of codification of 44 labor laws into 4 labor codes. This latest version dealt on only the social security. And as in the earlier codes, the whole aim of those health exercise is to take away the rights and protection related provisions of the existing social security bills in favor of the employers. The bill is combining all these acts in the social security code, and finally they are going to repeal these laws which are existing today. And while combining these, they have selectively lifted the provisions from the original laws, either in respect of EPF or ESI or gratuity. They have selectively picked up to put it here, along with a common provision for all the chapters. That is, empowering the government and bureaucracy in changing any of the provisions through executive decision. Earlier, if you had to change the gratuity model, you have to come to parliament and pass a bill. If you have to change anything on the EPF contribution and others, you have to come to parliament and change the bill. Similarly, on ESI contribution. Now they are trying to take up power within the government, that without any consultation in the tripartite board or tripartite committees, they can go ahead by changing the contributions made to these schemes, both by employees and by employers, and their main target is to reduce the contribution obligation of the employers and also moderate or change many beneficial schemes which are written in these laws, EPF, ESI, gratuity and all other things. So the whole democratic content of these existing laws, because all these existing law came up through the process of the united movement of the working class. Now they are trying to take away the democratic content so that they can, through their executive power, reduce the obligation of the employers more and more towards this social security scheme. This one of the most philistine motive behind the government, behind this exercise, is this. These schemes are meant mainly for the organized sector workers. So far as the unorganized sector workers is concerned, one of the major bill is Building and Construction Welfare Board bill. There also, government has kept unto themselves the number of discretionary power so that they can increase or reduce the benefit. We are going to have a detailed study on it, be clause by clause. But overall reading, on a preliminary reading, reveals that philistine motive of the government, that in the days to come, the power, they are enabling themselves to empower themselves so that whatever benefits are written, are there in these, all these social security scheme, can be changed by the government as per their goodwill. And definitely when government will change, they will change in favor of the employers. As we have already seen that in ESI, they have reduced the contribution of the employers, reduced the contribution of the workers also by 0.5%, but reduced the contribution of the employers more than 1%. Like that, I am just giving you an example. Similarly, on EPF bill, separately government mooted an amendment proposal, and that proposal now they are including in the social security code, that government may change the rate of contributions in EPF as and when it deem fit. And their main target is to reduce the contribution to be made by the employers. Because so far as the employees is concerned, there is a provision on the EPF Act, and they are keeping that provision intact, that if any employee wants to give more money contribute in their EPF scheme, they can do it. Although it will not be have a matching contribution of the employers beyond 12%. So, this is one about the social security scheme. And so far, the other general unorganized sector workers, beyond construction workers, there is an omnibus kind of scheme. But details are not worked out here, how people will be benefited on that. It is presumed that already the number of scheme that was announced by the government in the matter of pension and other things by general people, not workers as such, I think those schemes ultimately has to be migrated to this overall social security code. It is, and if that is done, even that scheme also do not ensure right at this moment any pensionary or social security benefit to the existing workers. This scheme speaks about that only after 30 years of contribution to be made by the workers, after 30 years they are going to get the benefit, and nobody knows after 30 years what will happen. The trade union movement is telling that for the unorganized sector workers, there should not be, it should not be a contributory scheme. The government must take the whole, own the entire responsibility of funding. Because unorganized sector workers are not having continuous work in all the days in a month and also all the months in a year. So, their contribution may get impeded at time to time. It may stop also. And for being unable to contribute, ultimately whatever they will contribute, their social security right will go away. That danger remains with the scheme. So, all these things are not yet detailed out. But, after all, government want to give a message that we are doing so much for the unorganized sector workers, etc., etc. For similarly, only for this public relations purpose and to confuse the people, they are doing these things. We basically oppose this approach, and definitely we will also be sending clause by clause our views and what is to be done to the government after the detailed study of this. But this is the overall picture, and the most notorious is that even if a scheme is put in motion and it will be passed by the parliament, say if it is passed, but even after it is passed by the parliament, any change in between, government is usurping the executive power to change it without coming back to parliament. This is an wholly notorious and undemocratic exercise, and that will make the workers at the mercy of the government and the employers. This is what is about the social security code.